idea who I am. I think I'm somebody who's evolving every day, and I hope to be better today than I was yesterday and better tomorrow than I am today. It's not their shame. It's not their fault that they got, they were subject to sexual harassment or assault. That's the first thing that every survivor wants to hear. They just want that one person to believe them. They just want somebody to validate ki, yes, it happened to you, we believe you, and this is not your shame. That's all they need. It's not their fault, it's not their dress, it's not their hair, it's not their sleeveless, it's not their tattoo, it's not their skin color, it's not them being outspoken or not outspoken. It's not. It's never, ever, ever the survivor's fault. Person of every gender identity. If it is this difficult for women to come out and talk about sexual harassment and assault now, it is extremely difficult for men to talk about sexual harassment and assault. It's terrible for men because this society thrives on patriarchy, and it questions the very masculinity of men who come and say that they have been assaulted or raped by other men. And then where are the laws for trans people to come and talk about rape and sexual assaults on them? How are you going to collect evidence for it? All of this needs to be done now, and it's urgent. It has to be done right now. Unfortunately, for people to take rape laws seriously, Nirbhaya had to be raped. Unfortunately, for safety at the workplace, Bhavani Devi ji had to be gang raped. Unfortunately, for people stop shaming women about wearing dupatta or not wearing dupatta, Disha had to be raped. Until then, we had to keep telling people, and people would say, why are you doing unnecessary drama? Even during Disha's rape, there were people who were checking what was she wearing. Before I finished school, I had started studying German, and that was how I ended up starting a language services company called Blue Elephant. And it gave me a very, very refreshing change from the usual creative processes that I'm used to. I really liked being a part of it. The company is still working, and one of the most beautiful experiences of running something with regard to language is that it opens your mind about culture. It opens your mind about how beautiful language is, and how very important it is to preserve and practice and keep languages alive.